In today's episode of Infertility TV, I will answer questions such as, what if you have tried Clomid and you didn't conceive? Should you try again? How many times should you use Clomid before quitting or moving on to some other fertility treatment? What are the odds for achieving pregnancy on the first try or the fifth? Stay tuned to the end of this video for my Infertility TV bottom line. Clomid is one of the most commonly used fertility medications for females. It is inexpensive, easy to use, and has low risks. It is therefore one of the first fertility treatments that doctors will try. Clomid is used in women for two different reasons. One reason is to try to get ovulation to occur in women who don't ovulate. The second is to try to increase the chance for pregnancy in women who already ovulate. Clomid is usually given for 5 days in a row. After that, it is important to monitor for ovulation. This can be done in the doctor's office with blood tests and ultrasounds, or at home with an ovulation test kit. On the day of ovulation, pregnancy is attempted by having intercourse or by placing sperm into the uterus. This is known as an intrauterine insemination, or IUI. 1 week later, a blood test can be done to verify that ovulation occurred. The week after that, another blood test is performed to see if pregnancy has occurred. The time from when you started Clomid until the pregnancy test is referred to by fertility doctors as one Clomid cycle. How many times should you repeat a Clomid cycle before deciding to move on to something else? There isn't going to be a single number for everybody. Part of that decision process is going to be based on non-medical factors, such as whether you have insurance coverage for treatment or whether you're squeamish about using injections, which are often used in the next steps. Some medical factors include a woman's age and her partner's sperm quality. Older women have lower success rates and so may move on more quickly. Couples with very, very low sperm numbers or poor sperm motility have lower success rates with Clomid, and so they may want to move on more quickly also. Another question is whether Clomid becomes less effective over time. Most studies only give an overall chance of success, but don't distinguish success rates based on how many attempts a couple has tried. Therefore, I looked at our own data here at IVF1. We have treated patients with Clomid thousands of times. I have looked at patients in whom the female partner was under the age of 35. Since patients don't stay with us for their entire pregnancy, I will give you the ongoing pregnancy rate. These are patients who had a viable pregnancy on ultrasound when we sent them back to their obstetrician. Studies show that this is pretty close to the delivery rate. On their first attempt with Clomid, just over 14% of our patients produced an ongoing pregnancy. In their second and third cycles, it was just over 13%. On the fourth and fifth tries, 11% of the patients were pregnant. We didn't have very many couples who did a seventh or eighth cycle, but the few we did have still had about an 11% pregnancy rate. Many doctors want to push their patients onto other treatments like IVF after only a few attempts. This is not mandatory, since pregnancy rates per cycle are still very reasonable, even through 8 cycles. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. There are medical and non-medical reasons why patients may want to stop using Clomid and move on to other treatments. If, however, the female is young, ovulation is occurring, and sperm numbers are reasonable, it is okay to consider doing a higher number of Clomid cycles. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.